The next show is planned for April 9th, 2022. It's about 29 weeks to bring something really special to the stage. I am very confident that that's gonna happen. Chest and arms on deck today. I apologize for the sleepy eyes. It was a bit of a restless sleep last night. We're starting to get prep insomnia, which is always fun. You guys saw at the start of the video, 161 pounds, so we're getting low now. on stage last time, I was low 150s, 153, 154, probably a little bit higher than that after carbing up, but when it came to actually making weights, it was right around that number for the show. So we're like less than 10 pounds over previous stage weight. And I've looked at photos of what I looked like before the show last time and where I'm at right now. And very, very comparable, you know, probably almost the same conditioning I am right now as I was, you know, getting ready to go on stage in 2019. And you know, around 10 pounds heavier. So that's a really positive sign that we've put on a good amount of muscle since last time, which is obviously super exciting. Overall, this week's been different because we have the holidays this weekend. We've, you know, Cliff kind of coined it as banking calories. But basically, you know, if you have a calorie allotment over the course of a week, people think of it, you know, strictly just one day. But if you branch it out and think of it over the course of like a 7-day period, you have X amount of calories, and then obviously that's broken into protein, carbs, and fats. What we're doing is basically banking a good amount of calories in the form of carbs for Christmas festivities this weekend. Carrie and I have, you know, quite a bit of family stuff over Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, Boxing Day. So what I've done is basically pull all my carbs from my last meal, which is quite a bit. It was around 60 grams, and I've pulled that out of that last meal all week. I'm recording this on Thursday, so we're starting to feel it. Yesterday I was pretty beat by the end of the day, and then obviously not really getting much of a recharge for that last meal. You know, getting up in the morning and, you know, getting a little bit of carbs in before the workout is important, but not having that pre-bed carbs is also probably why I'm not sleeping as well. But anyways, we're using the calories that we're saving all week to then use for Christmas meals and stuff like that. So that's the approach we've taken for the holidays. Obviously, there's different ways you can do things, but that's the kind of the method he's advised me to do. We're still at a really good spot this far out from the show. I'm not disclosing exactly how far out, but this far out. So I'm pretty happy. But anyways, and I'm not going to ramble on any longer. We're getting ready to go train. Like I said, we got chest and arms on deck today. So with this session, I like to, you know, really get a good pump. So I actually use both a stim and then a pump pre-workout. So for the stim, which has a lot of citrulline and stuff in it too, so you're gonna get a good pump regardless, but I like to top it up. So we've got Batch 27 White Freezy. The label being White Freezy is kind of it's not what you think it is. It's very much, I would have called it grapefruit. The flavor has grown on me. At the start, I really didn't care for it. I'm not a huge grapefruit fan, but it's starting to grow on me, and adding in this, which is the pump product, Impact Pump Blue Raspberry, it's actually a really good combo. So that's something my client Jeff advised me of, and it's really good. So I like to save it for this workout because A, tastes really good and it's something different to look forward to, and B, it really adds to the session from both an energy and a pump standpoint. So I'm gonna mix this up, then we're gonna go walk the dog, and then I'll catch you guys out in the gym. All right, that is a wrap for the workout. I don't know if you guys noticed, but it's a little different. We're doing some rearranging
and looking maybe get some new equipment next week, which is obviously very exciting. A little Christmas present to myself. But anyways, I want to talk about, which is, you know, the subject matter of the thumbnail, the title of the video, probably why you clicked on this video, and it's how I've lost basically 40 pounds without doing any cardio. Now, this isn't special to me. It's not like there's something special about me in that I can, you know, lose all this body fat without doing any cardio, because, you know, historically speaking, when I've had to prep for shows, I've had to do a lot of cardio. But there are some things I wanted to talk about which have aided me in, you know, prepping and losing 40 pounds so far without, you know, any programmed cardio. Number one, and the most important one that I want to talk about, is what I've done prior to prep to get me to the point where I've been able to do no cardio and lose all this body fat. So when it comes to the off season and, you know, gaining phases, improvement phases, you know, times where you're pushing your body weight up and trying to build muscle, you're obviously consuming more calories to aid in that process. And this past off season, I pushed my body weight up to the highest it had ever been, knocking on 200 pounds, which for me, that's heavy. I'm, you know, right around 5'7", so that's a lot of body weight to carry on my frame. And, you know, it definitely paid off, but it was not easy. It wasn't a walk in the park. It may sound glamorous eating a lot of food, but trust me, it's, at that point in the game, it's just as challenging as, you know, prepping in a sense, it just in different manners. But what that did was it built my calories up to a very high point. I was eating, you know, anywhere from 4,500 to 5,000 calories on a very, very consistent basis. And that supported me being able to now, you know, diet on higher calories and get into a deficit without needing to do cardio to, you know, add more expenditure and, you know, further that deficit. So right now I'm right around 2,600 calories, which may sound like a lot, but when you compare that to the 4,500 to 5,000 I was eating before, you know, that's a 2,000 calorie deficit. So, you know, losing weight on a 2,000 calorie deficit, it's not complicated, right? So the time period that I spent beforehand setting myself up for prep is the most important factor. And it's over a long period of time, right? I was in the off season for, you know, 1.5 to 2 years consistently, and I haven't been on stage since 2019, it'll be 3 years. So I've had a long period of time to, you know, put myself in a position where I can now prep in a different manner than I had before, in the form of not doing any cardio. Point number two I want to touch on is my daily expenditure. From the moment I get up, I am basically on my feet all day. I don't do physical labor, right? I'm not in construction or a mechanic or anything like that, but I'm on my feet all day, which is obviously burning more calories than if I was sat at a desk all day. So from the moment I get up till probably like 8 o'clock at night, I'm standing, right? Whether I'm working out or I'm at work or, you know, I'm walking the dog or whatever it is, I'm on my feet all day. So I'm burning calories, right? So when it comes to overall lifestyle factors, that is a huge one, along with what I mentioned first with building my calories up. Having a lifestyle that is, you know, in a sense active all day, it's very, very important, right? And it's something that not a lot of people think about. They're like, oh, you're just, you know, walking around at work, or you're walking around the gym, or you're standing in a stationary position. That, the amount of calories you can burn in comparison to someone who's sitting at a desk all day, it's a dramatic difference. So something to think about, and something that you can implement in your daily routine of, you know, getting up and just moving more. And point number three, and this is something that, you know, you've heard me talk about it repeatedly, and it's just the consistency of it. I've been, you know, following the plan and doing what I need to do, you know, for a long time now, right? Long before prep. Like, I've been living this bodybuilding lifestyle for, you know, going on a decade now, right? So all that compounds into getting you and, you know, getting me into a position where I'm able to prep in the manner that I am. Have I been perfect? Of course not. And I think anybody that says they're 100% perfect all the time, I think they're lying, right? Whether there's those 1 or 2% or 10% or whatever, those little hiccups along the way. But I really, really think that if you can be on point, you know, 80 to 85% of the time, you will be more consistent long term, because you're probably not gonna burn yourself out, and, you know, you're gonna get results a bit more effectively. So that consistency, that structure over a long period of time, you know, is the third point I want to talk about, because it's something that I think people still ignore, and they still don't appreciate how much that can really pay off. So yeah, guys, just wanted to touch on that because I think it's a super interesting thing to think about. I did not think I'd be the position I am in the conditioning that I am now without any cardio at all. You know, it's been a very good learning experience for me, obviously working with Cliff, a very high profile coach, just learning from him, you know, not only as an athlete, but as a coach myself, and just, you know, learning different methods and how you can structure things to be, you know, more effective and all that kind of stuff has been really good. So, yeah, I'm going to stop rambling now. We're almost 6 minutes in this clip. So, I'm going to go get cleaned up and, head off to work and just trucking along, right? We are X number of weeks out. And, you know, I feel good. I'm excited. And, you know, this will be the last video, obviously, before Christmas. So I wish you all a very Merry Christmas, time with family. Enjoy it. Really just take it all in. You know, the world's still crazy right now. So, you know, just really embrace and enjoy that time with family because it's the most important thing. So thanks for watching, guys. If you liked the video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you are new. And I'll see you guys in the next one.